Thao and Mustafa, we're here today talking because it's World Refugee Day. And when I was thinking about this day and how to recall my own family, my own roots, and all the refugees who have made such a difference for America, how really America is filled with refugees, I realized that of the 13 people on the Deputy Secretary's staff, two were refugees, the two of you. And so I thought there was nothing more appropriate for this day than to give you a chance to tell your stories about what it meant to you to come to this country, under what circumstances you came, and what made you end up in the Foreign Service, having started your lives in such a different place. So Mustafa is the Chief of Staff, so we're going to let him start first. And you have a really powerful story, Mustafa. Maybe you could tell our viewers a little bit about your background.
Sure. I was born in Afghanistan. I was about 5 years old when the Soviet invasion happened. And about that time, my family decided to flee Afghanistan. My father fled first. He was under danger, and his life was threatened by the Communist Party in Afghanistan. So he was fortunate enough to leave first, leaving my mother and I with my siblings behind, because it was the only way for him to actually get out. So he fled to India initially during the chaos of the Afghan regime there. And subsequently, my mother and I, my siblings, were able to escape as well, fortunately. And we lived in the Middle East for a few years. My father worked there, but he always had his eyes set on the United States. And we moved to the U.S., came here as refugees, and sought political asylum when I was about 11.
Wow. Well, I want to come back to you in a minute, but Thao, you have a different story, one that many of us have, as Americans, people my age, lived your story during the Vietnam War from a very different perspective. So tell us a little bit about your background.
That's right. I was born decades after the end of the Vietnam War, but to me, my story started when the Vietnam War ended. My father worked with the Democratic Southern Vietnamese government. And when the war ended in 1975, the government collapsed and the communist government took over. And they arrested everyone with ties to the Southern Vietnamese government, including my dad. And they imprisoned those folks in what they call re-education camps. But essentially, it was imprisoned just based on their political beliefs. And my dad was imprisoned for more than 5 years. And because of that, my family ultimately qualify to come to the U.S. under a program that I believe PRM started.
Population Refugees and Migration Bureau.
Exactly. They initiated a program called Humanitarian Operation. And my dad qualified because he was in prison for more than 5 years. And because the U.S. government believed that if he were to continue to stay in Vietnam any longer, our family would be in danger and face a lot of harassment, again, purely for his political beliefs. So my family was very fortunate to qualify under this program. And we moved to the U.S. when I was 7 years old, just so we have, my parents believe that I would have better opportunities in the U.S. to pursue an education.
So both of you have very compelling stories. I think most Americans don't understand what it means to be a refugee, to seek refuge in the United States. And so I'll start with you, Tan. Why did you go into the Foreign Service? I would think, you know, some people might think having lived the life you have, your father having had such a horrible time in prison, having been part of the South Vietnamese government, that you would want to stay far away from foreign policy and maybe pursue something else entirely.
And actually, that's what my parents would say as well. Why did you go into government? We want you to stay as far away from government as possible because that's what landed my father in prison. But I grew up in Washington, a very international city, and was exposed to a lot of exchange programs run by the State Department. And I did a program where I was able to go to China as an exchange student, and I loved the experience and wanted to pursue it as a career. But more than that, I wanted to pursue a career that would position me to do the type of work that helped save my family and help land us in the United States. So being a diplomat is perfect for that. I served as a human rights officer in Panama, as well as Chengdu, China, where I, through my reporting, I was able to help advocate for a lot of human rights activists and religious freedom advocates so that they could be in a position similar to my father and my family.
And you, Mustafa, why did you end up here?
I ended up here for a number of reasons. One was my father wanted to be a diplomat in Afghanistan, but he never had the chance. It was not a meritocratic system. And so growing up, I was always sort of exposed to culture and history. And I remember as a kid, before even coming to the States, reading Time magazine and seeing photographs at the time of President Reagan and what sort of the United States represented abroad. And when I had the opportunity in college, I studied international relations, and I was fascinated with travel and culture and world history, and learned about the Foreign Service and realized that, you know, it is a lifestyle more than a career. And when I was 18, I, you know, was making the choice between becoming a doctor and becoming a diplomat, and I realized that I was more drawn to the life of a diplomat being abroad, and particularly the representing the United States was of great interest to me, given sort of where we had come from and where we were in the U.S. And, you know, like Taiwan, I grew up in the D.C. area, Northern Virginia, and it's a, you know, very multicultural city, as you know. But representing the U.S. abroad has been a great honor and privilege, and serving in so many different places. She's spent much of her time in East Asia, and me, I've been mostly in the Middle East and Central Asia. And so having similar experiences of representing U.S. values and our diplomatic message and interacting with people abroad has just been very enriching on a personal level.
So let me ask you each one last question. Having been a refugee, and we are here on World Refugee Day, International Refugee Day, what do you take with you in your work every day, given the experience you've had and the life that brought you here? Start with Mustafa and end with Thao. Mm-hmm.
I think just enormous gratitude, and just when you sit back and you think about where you are, and in our case, we're working in the office of the Deputy Secretary, which is a tremendous privilege, and you kind of have to sit back and kind of pinch yourself and realize, you know, what we're doing, and has tremendous impact, not just globally, but, you know, on behalf of the American people, and on any given moment, we're working on such an array of different issues that you then realize that, you know, the United States is truly, you know, the land of opportunity, and, you know, if by good fortune, hard work, and there, it is a meritocratic system.
And Talon, you told me something about what you carry with you every single day. Maybe you can share that with our viewers.
Sure. I always carry the story of my dad and how he landed in prison simply for his values and beliefs. And so I really want to join the Foreign Service for that reason, so that I could be in a position to help people who are just like him. And like Mustafa, my family and I are extremely, extremely grateful that we're here in the U.S. And we're able to serve people and, you know, to go out there and represent the U.S. is such a tremendous, tremendous honor. And to be able, you know, I'll tell you a very quick story, but when I was a human rights officer in Chengdu, people, every time they were in trouble, human rights activists, the first place that they think of is the U.S. consulate. They want to come and seek help, our help, because they know we will help them. And what's more important, what strikes me as something very valuable, is that they believe in the values, American values, and that we the values that we espouse, human rights. You know, we shelter people who are in need of a place of safety. And so I hope that, you know, the work that we do every day in the Office of the Deputy Secretary specifically, but at large, the State Department, can help advance these values so that people who are living in troubled places, who are seeking for a democracy, can have the same lives that we have here, and can pursue their own ambitions the way that we're free to do here.
Thank you both for sharing your stories with us. I know that when I thought about this and realized that the two of you had been refugees yourselves, and now we're doing the work that you're doing, it just reinforced for me how much refugees have mattered to the depth and breadth of America, for the diversity of America, for the entrepreneurial and free spirit of America. I'm really proud to have you on our staff and part of our team, and I know your stories will help emphasize how important it is that we lift up people who seek shelter and refuge, and that we always support them to come to America. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.